for moksha. So, and the question is, that's why I mentioned that, that does that mean that Shudras cannot have? No, I told you that of every guna, there is a good aspect too. So the Shudra can take the Seva Bhav and make it so good and dedicate that Seva Bhav to the highest. And I will give you a...
No, good and bad is our classification.
True, true. Okay, forget because, about the word.
Because Raman got moksha because he got killed because he was so bad.
No, no, so, I know, but uska to we have to go behind stories, you know, true, true. So what all I'm trying to say over here is this. No matter what gunas you are born with, according to Bhagavad Gita, if you follow this journey that he's talking about, you can get moksha. You don't have to wait so many lives, oh, I have to experience this also, that. That's where I differ with you a little bit, which is okay, because...
No, because I believe in destiny. I don't believe that all this we are doing is going to make a big difference. The only reason we are doing, because we are destined to do that.
Okay, so I think that...
You can be mad about it.
I'm not expressing anything of my opinion here. Yeah, I do believe in Bhagavad Gita, but whenever I say something, I am bringing it out from Bhagavad Gita, from whatever I have learned. And for this class, that's a better thing to do, in my opinion. At least try to understand from one end to the other the entire Bhagavad Gita and then form your opinions. You know?
No, but even in Bhagavad Gita, he told the Maran Vidya, which says, no matter who you are, you can follow this Om thing and become merge and get your moksha.
Well, if you understand that correctly, it sounds very simple, right? It sounds like, let me tell you, because you know, the thing is that it's better to know the context of it, because in Bhagavad Gita, nothing is simple. Okay, because it's a deeper subject. So if there is one word, there is a vast application, and then you have to understand from entire spectrum and then make the judgment. So what you said, it said that before dying, if you can think of Bhagwan, you will get moksha. One way to think of Bhagwan is Om, because we understood Om is what? Symbol of that Paramatma. Now the question is, if you are dying, what is the possibility that you will be in that mode?
If that, you can detach from everything you have.
Yeah, let me finish.
And think of,
yeah. If you have trained your mind in your previous time, in many, many, many years, to be in that mode, you will be in that mode. Agar tum ye soch lo ki main sari zindagi, you know, I chase the worldly stuff and suddenly while dying, all I have to do is remember Om. Bilkul yaad nahi aayega Om tumko. So when the chips are down, when tumhari saanse nahi aa rahi hai, tum mar rahe ho, wo time pe jo most predominant thought hota hai na, तुम्हारी लाइफ का वो आके खड़ा हो जाता है. अगर तुमने पूरी जिंदगी खाली बिजनेस और कुछ नहीं सोचा, वो टाइम भी तुम यही सोचोगे, हाय मेरा बिजनेस का क्या होगा. और इफ यू आर वेरी अटैच्ड टू योर चिल्ड्रन, देन यू ओह उसको भी बुला. सो दैट्स व्हाट इट इज जो. दैट्स हाउ आई अंडरस्टूड दैट एट द लास्ट मोमेंट, इफ यू वांट टू से ओम और यू वांट टू बी इन गॉड मोड, यू गॉट टू प्रैक्टिस इट फॉर द एंटायर लाइफ, देन यू विल बी, यू नो, दैट इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट.
No, but even in this sentence, he's saying it does not matter who you are, whether you are sattvic, rajasic, tamasic.
I already said it does not matter.
Dharma.
I don't dispute about that. I'm not disagreeing with you about that.
That's what he's talking about.
Yes.
All I'm saying is one should not feel guilty about it that I'm Shudra. I mean, I could have been a sattvic person in my previous life. And this
verse is not saying that. In fact, the word guilty... उसका सारा प्रॉब्लम ही होता कि डोंट हैव गिल्ट एंड ग्रीफ एंड दिस एंड दैट. भगवान डजंट वांट यू टू हैव गिल्ट अबाउट एनीथिंग. एंड दैट्स व्हाई एंड गीता जी ब्रॉट दैट पॉइंट दैट इवन इफ यू हैव योर ड्यूटी व्हिच लुक्स हॉरिबल फ्रॉम द वर्ल्डली पर्सपेक्टिव. अभी गार्बेज उठाने वाला, यू नो, हम जो पढ़े लिखे लोग होते हैं, दे लुक डाउन अपॉन इट. आई डोंट वांट गो टू दैट स्टिंकी थिंग एंड पिक अप एवरीबॉडीज गार्बेज. वो कर रहा है ना, और वो नहीं करेगा तो हमारा नुकसान होगा. थिंक अबाउट इट. And he also has a chance to become moksha, because if he does his job perfectly well and dedicates it to God, I'm doing it for God, he will get the moksha. Ab padhe likhe log baithe reh jayenge. So I'm not disagreeing with you at all. That's not what this verse is saying by any means. What it's saying is understand what these gunas are, understand what is your swadharma and act accordingly, dedicating it to God. Act in the karma yoga mode if you want to get moksha.
Right.
That's what it's telling you. So it's not telling you that, oh, sit down and try to change, force your mind to become sattvic and all that. No. And in fact, that brings me to a very important point that one of the Swami said, everybody agrees that we have all three gunas, right? He said, make use of all three gunas in your life for the good of the humanity. How? Your sattvic guna that you have, gain the knowledge. Share the knowledge with other people. You know, learn to meditate and all that. So, wo sattvik ho gaya. Rajasik, you know, develop things like fearlessness, adventure, you know, taking risk, you know, doing new things. Do that in your life with your rajasik guna that you have. Produce something, be creative, come up with new things in your life, you know, and you know, produce more than what you take, like they say, you know. You know, go and earn over there so you can donate and take care of your family and have enough money to donate also. Do that. And what do you do with the tamasic, you know, like shudra quality? Seva karo. You know, without expecting anything. So you can make use of all the gunas, but you should know the mechanism of it. That's what this whole thing is about. It's not about somebody's better than other, change this, change that, none of that. But suppose, okay, I'm giving an example. Suppose I have too much of a rajasi thing in me, rajasi guna, and I want to sit and meditate. So mujhe kya karna hoga? Mujhe thoda sattva gun badhana padega mujhe, right? I might have to, you know, balance it out my life. I might have to learn to be quiet and all that. Tum apna sattva gun bada rahi ho ki nahi? Because I want to do certain thing. So this, all these concepts and everything have to be taken with the totality of what we are learning. Don't take it in lits and bits and pieces, because you will misunderstand it. That's my recommendation. Okay. So what we're going to do is, since this is such a heavy subject, you know, we have just another 5 minutes to discuss this, and we will read it next time about Swamiji has his own points and all that, because it's, even if we do it over two times, it's not a bad thing. So we have 5 minutes. If somebody has a burning thing about this to discuss right now.
Yeah, what I understood from reading one or two Gitas is that, you know, men are actually, when you're worshipping the demigods, because the devas likha hai na yahan par, that means you get only temporary success. And you get immediate relief, but it's only temporary thing. But if you worship Krishna, then you get the, you know, spiritual and the true bliss. So, and he's saying, so, and you are accruing from activity. Whenever man is using his mind, he's actually going to be doing activities. So when you want to achieve Krishna, then you have to actually remove your mind from the activities and meditate to get Krishna. That's what it is. So if you are going to have your mind in activity, you're not going to achieve God. You have to withdraw your mind.
There's a little confusion in your Sneha. So that's not what Bhagavad Gita approaches. What Bhagavad Gita is saying, if you do your activities dedicating to God, that's what counts. If you do it with egoism, then it's not going to get you anywhere. And when you said, when you believe in Krishna, there are people out there who believe Krishna as a body. They don't understand who the Krishna is. When Krishna says worship me, he's not telling worship me just my body's akar or something. He's telling you through me, understand what the Bhagwan is. That's another very, very important part.
See, thinking of Krishna is also an activity. So you do whatever activity you're doing, but dedicate it to him. That is the whole point.
Dedicate to the, by understanding who Krishna is, who right. That Paramatma is, and also that's the most important thing. But what, according to Krishna Bhagwan, if you do your actions, without action, to hum reh nahi sakte. Koi bhi 24 ghante to meditate nahi kar sakta. Right? सो हमको उठ के करना, और स्पेशली हमारी ड्यूटीज होती है इतनी सारी, यू नो. सो डज दैट मीन अ हाउस वाइफ कैन नॉट गेट अ मोक्षा और सम इंजीनियर और डॉक्टर? नो, दे कैन गेट इट टू, बट दे हैव टू डू दे हैव टू डेडिकेट देयर एक्शन टू भगवान एंड दे हैव टू कम आउट ऑफ दिस डूअरशिप. ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट ना अंडरस्टैंड माय जन्म एंड माय कर्म एंड अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज डन बाय प्रकृति. अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू नो आई एम एट दैट हाइएस्ट लेवल. मेरा भी जन्म नहीं होता बट ये बॉडी जन्म लेती है. दैट्स वॉट आई हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. You know, that's how it is. So even there are a lot of commentaries out there, but through the commentary we have to understand the essence of it. Because if we take just the superficial meaning, then we will not understand the depth of it. You know, that's what happens.
Good. That was conclusion.
Anybody else wants to express anything about this? I think it's a great eye-opener, no, about the Chaturvarna. And I would say that, you know, anybody who has this kind of confusion in your family or friends or relatives, try to, you know, tell them about this verse. So, unki bhi misunderstanding khatam ho jayegi. You know, the world will be a better place, you know, if you understand what it is. I was totally thrilled to learn this. And, you know, I make sure that, you know, in my 10th grade, when this topic comes, I tell the kids and they're also very happy to learn that. And all of a sudden, you know, it's like, wow, this makes so much sense. It's so scientific, especially when you give the, you know, example of, hey, in our city, you know, if one of the garbage men start working, there'll be a huge chaos. So you cannot say that, you know, only the guy who's sitting as an executive in a company is important. From the government perspective, everybody's equal. You know, you cannot discriminate like that.
Actually, Umaji, I was reading chapter 7th in Bhagavad Gita. And over there was one verse. They were explaining the same thing about the caste system. And I was doing with my daughter-in-law, Monica was sitting, and my two granddaughters. All of a sudden, Monica said, wow, this is a totally different thing what we are learning up to now. You know? Yes. We think that our caste system is... But here, Gita is explaining the totally different thing what we knew since then. I say, yeah, you can see it right now.
Yes.
And
yes.
Exactly same thing which you're telling right now, just like a few months back, you know.
Yeah. And this whole thing is going to continue. Every concept in Bhagavad Gita opens up more and more and more, and then in the 18th chapter he goes in much more detail about it, everything. So we will see, and that's why we need to have patience to learn the entire spectrum of what Bhagwan is saying. Then we will get a better idea of everything. Yeah, Gita, you have something?
Yeah, so in conclusion, are we saying that Bhagwan or the consciousness created humans purposely with these four tendencies?
No, that's not what we're saying. No.
The four tendencies of a Brahman tendency, Kshatriya tendency, Vaishya and Shudra tendencies in order to run society. Because I think you just said that if we all sat and just meditated, then who will run society?
See, Bhagwan did not create that way.
Oh.
It took natural course of people. And now the question is that, because this question, one of the students in my class in Chinmaya Mission asked, if Bhagwan is all pure and all, where did the impurities came from? These are impurities, right? Like, you know, all the different... you know, what you call negativity. That's why they call it Maya, or, you know, hey, I forgot who I am. That's why the world got created. That's another way of looking at it, you know.
Who forgot?
You can say self-forgetfulness of that Brahman. When you say who forgot, Brahman. If I forget who I am, then I start doing certain things not knowing who I am. That's all. But where did it came from? So, it's not a very easy thing to answer, but Swami Chinmayananji answered it with an example. I thought it was very, very beautiful because I'm translating, that's why I know. So this is what he said.
These four items are in every action we do. We need somebody who we give order and they do the actual work.
That's not what she's asking. She's asking, did Bhagwan create that? And
no,
we are...
Bhagwan didn't create that. That is the way the nature works.
Yeah, so I was just bringing the point that he gave the example that Ganga ka pani jab shuru hota hai, to pure, suppose usme koi pure impurity nahi hai because it is like, the, it came from that process, you know, upar se aaya pani aur baraf ban gaya immediately, to pure hai ekdam, usme kuch bhi nahi hai, right? H2O is pure. So, at the essence, H2O always remains pure. Then Ganga behne lagi. To Ganga behne lagi, it started reacting with all the land and this and that, start picking up things. या कोई भी नदी हो, गंगा को छोड़ो, कोई भी नदी हो, जहां से वो आती है उसके उस धरती के गुण वो उठा लेती है, एंड देन यू किसी में कोई चीज मेटल है, किसी में कुछ है, वो सब उसमें भर जाता है, राइट? सो ना कोई बोलेगा वो गंदा हो गया, पानी गंदा हो गया, ऐसे नहीं, पानी नहीं गंदा हुआ है, उसमें कुछ मिल गया है. दैट्स ऑल इज हैपेंड एट अ सो देन वंस यू बॉइल इट अगेन यू कैन गेट H2O, राइट? सो ऐसे ही हम लोग भी हैं. हमारी जब जर्नी शुरू हुई तो फर्स्ट लाइफ में हमारा अटैचमेंट शुरू हो गया. भगवान ने तो प्योर प्योर भेजा था, फिर नेक्स्ट लाइफ वी कैप पिकिंग अप. नाउ दैट वी हैव लर्न गीता, वी थिंक कि सिट डाउन एंड बॉइल योर सेल्फ मीन्स तपस करो, ओके, हीट योर सेल्फ विद ऑल एंड देन बिकेम अगेन H2O. आई थॉट इट वाज सच अ ब्यूटिफुल एग्जाम्पल. सो वट इज हैपन्ड इज गीता जी, he's saying that this is part of the world. So the three gunas are part of nature. You know, so it's slightly complicated when you say, did God create? On one hand, yes, God is a substratum of everything. That's why he said
that. Just being very literal with this shlok, he's saying the fourfold caste was created by me, by the distribution. He's saying here very clearly that he created it. So he created.
But then that word, see, when the way we are taught in Chinmaya Mission, the Bhagavad Gita, you don't take the literal translation. You'll be in big trouble. You got to understand in from what angle he's talking about that I created it. It's something like this. The ornament and the gold. Can we say that the gold created the ornament from the perspective that without gold, no ornament is possible? From that perspective, it was created. Or the ocean and the waves. I cannot say that, you know, I can say that waves are created by the ocean. Don't we say that? Waves are created by the ocean. But from the ocean's perspective, ocean has not created anything. There's a slight disturbance is there. It's part of the ocean only. Ocean says, you're not separate. You are me only. From there, we have to see what that means, created. Not that he took some material and created it. Not that way, creation. That's not what they're talking about. Everybody think about this and then we can take it up again. Because these are things that we cannot solve it in one shot. It requires a lot of thinking. But this much, most of the Swamis have commented like that on it. That when they talk about creation, it is talking about from that substratum perspective. You know, that without that, it's not possible. That's why he becomes a creator. So what we will do is, we will stop here, Bhagavad Gita. Everybody think about it. You can bring your questions next time.
In our thing, what they have said is God didn't create these gunas, but God has actually created the cosmic intelligence, the energy, the organization, law and cosmic motion. And these are reflected as the gunas in our body.
Yeah, you can say that. They can explain it. That's a good explanation too. And remember, Gita ji, in the same... He said that I created it. Now read the next line. What does it say? The literal translation.
Yeah. Though I be the author thereof, know me to be the actionless and changeless.
Yeah. Non-doer. So a person who is actionless, how can he create? right? So Vedanta is always talking contradiction because it is trying to jog your mind. So we cannot take it literally either. You have to take it holistically, the whole thing. That's the whole trick. And I think that I had mentioned it, that I think it was Sarup Priyananji, he said that one of the sadhus, you know, in the Himalayas told him that Hindi mein, sabhi ko Hindi aati hai na yahan pe, so you will appreciate this. He's saying, ki jab do virodhi cheez saath mein pakad mein aayegi na, tab Vedant pakad mein aayega. Because trying to catch both of them together, and then I gave the example that if I put a stone on the table and I say, is this moving or a non-moving thing? Most of us will say it's non-moving. But a scientist will say it's moving because all the molecules are moving inside. See that? So that's the whole idea. And then another thing about non-doing is when we read Swamiji's commentary, he's going to explain it. Why don't we do one thing? Whoever has the book, read Swamiji's commentary also before you come to the class. So then it'll be easier to discuss. Because he said that, you know, when we go in a train or a bus or a car, are we moving? What would you say? Let's just ask this question and then we will. What would somebody say? Are we moving or not moving?
We are moving along with the car. We are not moving, actually. The car is moving, but we are also.
See that? There's a confusion here. Am I moving? No, I'm just sitting. But I maine distance cover kar liya. Why? Because car ki jo guna hai, wo mere mein aa gayi. Car is taking me and maybe uske saath chal padi. That's why. Same type over here is. So even in the worldly thing, if this happens. On one hand, I say, yes, I moved because I did go from one. Another, no, I'm just sitting. I didn't do anything. And jo log passenger hote ho, to kuch bhi nahi karte. Baithe baithe pahunch jate hain. Because the qualities of the nature have been superimposed on that Brahman. And it looks like he's creating, but actually he's not. That's the whole concept over here. So think about all these things. Very, very, it'll jog your mind, challenge your mind. So I'm going to stop here, Bhagavad Gita, and we'll take up the questions either end or next time.
Start with the prayer.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll start with the prayer. Thank you, Neeliji. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahana Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahai Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. So we finished verse 24 last time, and Nachiketa was adamant. Yamraji is giving him all kinds, he's testing him, giving him all kinds of carrots in front of him. Ye bhi lele, wo bhi lele. That's where we are. Okay, and he's wo tas se mas nahi ho raha hai, you know. He told him that I'll make you the king now. Then last verse he said, ask for some other boon equal to this. And if you want, I can make you give you wealth. I can give you long life and make you the king of this world. And enjoyer of all the desires and all that. And Nachiketa ne koi reaction nahi diya ki bhi mujhe kuch chahiye. And Tejamananji is very funny. He said that when he was learning this from Chinmayananji. Chinmayananji has a lot of humor too. So he said ki, you know, koi cheez mein interest nahi hota na, to aadmi yahan wahan dekhne lagta hai. Right? So jaise Swamiji kehte hain, mera sunne mein maza nahi aa raha hoga, to aap log bhi yahan wahan dekhna shuru karoge. To usne aise nazar ghumayi na, to wahan apsaraen khadi hongi. So यमराज को लगा अच्छा मेरी इसको अप्सराओं में इंटरेस्ट है. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वर्ड्स नाउ. सो इसमें लिखा है 25 हूएवर हैज अ बुक ये कामा दुर्लभा मर्त्य लोके सर्वान् कामान् छन्दतः प्रार्थयस्व इमा रामः सरथा सतुर्या नहि हिदृशा लंबनिया मनुष्ये ही अभी मत प्रतापी परिचारस्य स्व नचिकेतो मरणम मा अनुप्राशि. Let's see the words. ये means whatever. कामा objects of desire. तुम्हारी जो भी object of desire होगी. दुर्लभा difficult to attain. तुम्हारी ऐसी डिजायर जो दुनिया में डिफिकल्ट टू अटेन है. मर्त्य लोके इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ मॉर्टल्स विच इज दिस पृथ्वी लोक. सर्वान ऑल कामान ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ डिजायर छंदंत अकॉर्डिंग टू योर चॉइस मीन्स तू चूज कर लेते को क्या लेना है. प्रार्थयस्व आस्क मी फॉर दैट इमाहा दीज मीन्स बेसिकली सेइंग कि टेल मी योर प्राइस व्हाट यू वांट. रामा फेयर मेडन्स यू नो यहाँ पर रामा का मतलब यू नो रामचंद्र जी नहीं है अप्सराएं जो रमण करती हैं प्लेजर्स में. दैट्स रामा. इट्स अमेजिंग उनको भी राम नाम मिल गया. सरथा विथ चैरियट्स यू नो तो अभी अपन चैरियट बोलेंगे इसमें सॉरी इसमें तो चैरियट बोला अभी सोच लो एप्पल कार और जो आने वाली है ना न्यू जनरेशन टेस्ला वो दे दूंगा मैं तुझे. सतुरिया म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यू नो किसी को म्यूजिक यहाँ पर म्यूजिक लवर्स हैं यू नो मीरा जी वगैरह तो बोले कि तुमको जो सुनने को चाहिए म्यूजिक हेवनली म्यूजिक सारे भेज दूंगा. ये जो यहाँ के जो हेवन वाले हैं ना उनको भेज दूंगा तेरे साथ वहाँ के रथ और वहाँ की मेडन्स और वहाँ के गाजे बाजे वाले सब उनके इंस्ट्रूमेंट के साथ. हाँ ऐसे ही नहीं सतुरिया इज द म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट नहीं नॉट इन डीड इदृशाहा सच दीज अराउंड हियर जो भी है लभन्या इंजॉयबल ऑब्टेनेबल मतलब गिविंग यू इमेंस प्लेजर इफ यू वांट देम टू मसाज योर फीट दे विल डू दैट टू बेसिकली यू नो ऐसे बोल रहे हैं. मनुष्य बाय मॉर्टल्स मतलब मॉर्टल्स जो जो डिजायर करते हैं ना मुझे ये मिल जाए वो सब मैं तुझे देता हूँ. आबी ही विद देम मत प्रतापी गिवन बाय मी. सो दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज कौन दे रहा है यमराज दे रहा है. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि लाइक तेजो मैंने इज वेरी फनी ही सेड ओ अप्सराओं को तो बोल दिया कि भाई जा इनके साथ. अप्सरा के यहाँ बोले नहीं नहीं मेरे को तो पसंद नहीं है ये यू नो ये वाला लोक इतना गंदा है यहाँ पे मैं तो जा रही हूँ वापस. ऐसा नहीं होगा मैंने ऑर्डर दिया है वो सब करेंगे तेरे को प्लीज करने दैट्स व्हाट इट गिवन बाय मी यू नो. परिचार्यस्व बी अटेंडेड ऑन सो मतलब वो तेरी परिचारिका बन जाएगी तेरे दास बन के तेरी सेवा करेंगी बेसिकली. नचिकेता ओ नचिकेता मरनाम डेथ मा डू नॉट अनुप्राशी क्वेश्चन अबाउट डू नॉट क्वेश्चन मी अबाउट द क्या होता है डेथ के बाद कौन बचता है ये सब छोड़ मैं तेरे को ये सब देता हूँ. That's what basically in this verse it's telling you. Giving him like maximum. So basically, you know, Swami Ji apni commentary mein batayenge ki agar hamare dil mein koi bhi desire baki reh jati hai na, phir hum moksh ki taraf nahi badh sakte. And if you remember in chapter 2 when we were doing Sthita Pragna ke lakshan, द मैन ऑफ रियलाइजेशन के लक्षण अर्जुन ने पूछा था कि हे वट आर द यू नो क्या बोला क्वालिटीज ऑफ ए रियलाइज पर्सन. द फर्स्ट वर्स दैट कृष्ण भगवान सेड फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ दैट फर्स्ट वर्स इज जिसकी सारी इच्छाएं खत्म हो चुकी हैं. ओके ही हैज नो डिजायर लेफ्ट. सो हियर द रीजन ही इज गिविंग हिम ऑल दिस you know carrots in front of him agar koi desire baki reh gayi hai to puri kar le because uske bina moksh mein nahi ja sakta. That's why he's doing it to take out the last desire if he has any. But Nachiketa is Nachiketa and I think that it was Tejo Mehna ji who said that lot of great saints and sages have done commentary on it So Shankaracharya ji, when he did the commentary, he said Nachiketa's mind was like a still lake. मतलब एक रिपल भी नहीं था उसमें कि भाई ये सब इतना सब फेंका उसमें तो कुछ रिपल होगा. नो, ही डिड नॉट मूव एट ऑल. एंड इन फैक्ट ही सेज आप अपने पास ही रख लो ये. मुझे नहीं, आई थिंक इन नेक्स्ट वर्स में आएगा वो, विच इज अ वेरी पावरफुल स्टेटमेंट दैट यू ओनली कीप इट बाबा, आई डोंट वॉन्ट इट, यू नो. आई जस्ट थ्रू दैट बिकॉज इट मेक्स इट मोर जूसी द स्टोरी. ओके, all right, who wants to read? Any question though on this? If I don't have volunteer, I'll have to pick someone. Good. Come on. Shireen.
Whatever desires are difficult to attain in this world of mortals, ask for them all according to thy wish. These fair maidens with their chariots and musical instruments, such indeed are not enjoyable by mortals, though be attended by them. I will give them to thee. But O Nachiketa, I do not question about the state of the soul after death. Or do not question about the state of the soul after death. Even a single unsuspected and unconscious desire worm lurking anywhere in the subconscious ruins the entire psychological makeup of a seeker. A true sadhaka who's marked out for success is he who has come to enjoy a balanced development of his physical, psychological, and spiritual personalities. If any one of them is distorted, then the entire combination becomes ill-adjusted, and from such a maladjusted instrument, no true music can emerge. As a true doctor of the soul, Lord Death requests Nachiketa not to insist upon knowing the state of existence after death, but to wish for any material gain or sensuous happiness which may be waiting in him for fulfillment. The student is offered the services of heavenly damsels, divinely beautiful and godly graceful chariots, horses, ornaments, whatnot.
So I think the main thing over here is that here when he's saying that, but to wish for any material gain or sensuous happiness which may be waiting in him for fulfillment, if he has any seed of desire, that's what basically the test is for. That hey, does he understand that, you know, that these things, and he's going to tell you in the next verse that no matter what you get, how long life you get, everything is temporary, you know. That's what it's not because we say, oh, why did he give up all that? If I know I can get $1 billion, will I worry about $5? That's what this whole thing, he know. And now that he offered him all this, because Nachiketa is of a high caliber, uski to value uski nazaron mein aur badh gayi na. कि अगर वो एक तरफ ये ज्ञान है और एक तरफ मुझे सब कुछ दे रहा है, मतलब दिस इज मोर प्रेशियस देन दैट, यू नो. सो दैट्स व्हाट, एंड नाउ आई वाज टेलिंग यू दैट इन भगवद गीता व्हेन वी लर्न दैट ह्यूमन बीइंग डोंट गो फॉर अवर मोक्षा बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव द वैल्यू फॉर इट, दैट्स व्हाई वी डोंट गो. एंड बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू भगवद गीता द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ एफर्ट कैन बी डन इन आइदर वन टू गेट वर्ल्डली थिंग्स और मोक्षा. But people don't go for it because they don't understand the value of it. That's what it is.
I would say they don't go for it because they're too busy with their, you know.
Why are they busy?
Oh, you don't understand the value. That's why you are busy.
Exactly. If you understood the value, then you will be in busyness. You will seek him. That's what it is. Mm-hmm. Because what Bhagwan says in chapter 9, you offer everything you do to me. And the example is given, I always give this example because this goes best with the children and I know that you will understand this very easily. If I go and become an ambassador of a country, when I go to that other country, my entire behavior have to represent America, if I go as American ambassador to another country, I cannot, my personal thing won't matter anymore, because whatever I do, hey, America is doing it. So you become the God's instrument of him. And that's how you, so when we say we are busy, we misunderstand. Bhagwan, in fact, Bhagwan to ulta bol rahe hai. Bhagwan to usko daat rahe hai, you get busy. What is he telling Arjun? Go fight. So we cannot misunderstand that Bhagwan is saying just sit around and laze. That's not what he's saying at all. He's saying do your work, understand only Prakriti is doing. You are not the doer, dedicated to me, be my instrument and work as though the entire world is one body. That's what he's telling you. Let's see. We can do the next one also, because these are like relatively simpler ones. Any question? Any more question on this? Or comment? Or somebody wants to add anything?
The shlok, she didn't read the whole thing. Should you read?
I read the whole thing, if that is in my book.
Yeah, that's all it is. It's a very short paragraph. You basically, you know, he told them that, you know, I gave you everything, all this heavenly. Pehle dunya ki cheeze de raha tha, ab heaven ka bhi de raha usko. Aur wo dusre dharmon mein hota hai na ki swarg milega agar koi jihad karoge, ye karoge, wo karoge. Unki bhi yehi desire hai na. Swarg mein gaya, wahan par all those virgins are there and think whatever, whatever, I don't know. That's what people desire. So isse main de deta hu tere ko sab kuch. So we did finish 25 reading also.
Can I just complete my thought? I'm sorry.
Yeah, of course.
What I meant to say is that, you see, now that we guys here are retired, we have the time to sit and study the Gita and understand God and what he wants from us and all the stuff that we're studying now, you know, which will help us to purify our minds, purify our motives, right? Until now, we were so busy just being students and then being young mothers and then being earning and raising a family and everything, that we didn't have the time to sit and study like this and understand God and intellectually, as you were saying.
You don't need to do that. That's what it is. It's because, see, when you are thinking that, I started when my kids were like in elementary school. And there were people who came to Chinmaya Mission who started studying Gita. They were students. And so when it comes in your life, that is more your own journey. It has nothing to do with, because I was busy, it happened. There are the people who are in Bal Vihar, you know, they are studying Bhagavad Gita. Imagine. And in your organization also, don't you teach little children? Nobody taught me, so I didn't think about that. But these kids do question. Who am I? Why am I here?
My own experience. I studied Gita when I was small in school, right? And after that, I got so busy that I just didn't have the time to continue the study of it. That's what I meant.
I think that what I am trying to shatter over here is that notion that because I am busy, I cannot get God. And Krishna Bhagwan is saying exactly ulta. He's saying you should get God while you are busy. That's what I am trying to shift your mind. If I understood correctly what Bhagwan is saying at an early age, I can still do everything that I want to and attain God.
Nee, but to clarify, Gita's thing is you don't have to have a dedicated time to remember God. You remember God in every action. So you're not having a dedicated, even however busy you are, if you're giving all the karma to the God itself, then you know, khana bhi bana rahe ho to unke praise mein unko bhog laga kar khana khao. खाना बना रहे तो उनकी प्रेज में गाना गाते हुए खाना बनाओ. So you are in that mode always, in God's mode.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's the message I was trying to give when I said chapter 9, he said dedicate everything to me. That's exactly right.
तो अभी लोरी सुना रहे हो तो भगवान की भजन सुना दो ना या भगवान का कर दो. So you are in that mode always.
Like this joke को जो assignment मिला हुआ है, see Bhagwan and his wife. Okay? जैसे इंडिया में बोलते हैं वो पति को मानो परमेश्वर. सो ये नहीं कहते कि वो पति माने कि मेरी वाइफ दासी हो. पति को भी देखना होता है वाइफ में देवी. एंड यू नो इट्स अ बोथ वेज. इंडिया में वो एक ही तरह का कर दिया, पति को मानो परमेश्वर.
आई फील अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ गिल्ट in Meera that why she couldn't, or Gita, that why she couldn't learn Gita before.
She did, but, she said.
But when your time comes, that's all. The only time you learn anything or do anything, because you get anand in that. So when you are busy doing other stuff, you will not get anand if you read Gita. But you will get anand in reading Gita when your time is there. And that's what happened to me. I mean, I had not heard of Gita till 56, age of 56. And then all of a sudden things started moving. So idea is that, but that again goes back to this argument of will versus destiny.
See, as far as Gita, studying Gita is concerned, Swamiji ka famous ek story hai ki bhai ek aadmi aaya Swami Chinmayananji ke paas aur bola, oh, Swamiji, I went through your Gita. So Swamiji ne pucha, did Gita go through you? That's the main thing. So I could be studying Gita 100 times, but nothing can go into my head. But what Joe is saying, and you know, if I think about when I picked up Gita, studying Gita on my own, and I didn't get anywhere. I was like, I went through and I could tell people, yeah, I read Gita, or I could tell myself. मेरे को कुछ ज़्यादा समझ में नहीं आया. ये पता चल गया क्या है, you know, हल्का फुल्का. फिर जब गौरंग भाई ने समझाना शुरू किया, दर्शना भाई ने समझाना शुरू किया वहाँ पर, तब जाके धीरे धीरे. And then when I became a Balveer teacher, then we had to study more and more and more. So the Gita is more like a महासागर. उसके you can keep going in and you know, even I don't know everything about it because there's so many aspects to it. And it's so well packed, but how much you understand maybe your own personal journey and it, many factors are involved in it. So, but one great thing that I found in it was anywhere, anytime, anybody, any age, anyone can start the journey. And you don't have to wait to finish X, Y, Z. And no matter how busy you are, or not busy, on that perspective, everybody's busy. You know, somebody has one X something, has Y, somebody has Z, you know, to work on. Or sabhi ko lagta hai ki mera hi time sabse zyada precious hai. That's another thing, very common thing, you know. So that's what it is. That it's like.
I remember one example of Ramakrishna and Vivekananda. Because Vivekananda came to Ramakrishna and he said, I learned this today, I read this book today and that book today.
Mm-hmm.
So Ramakrishna told him, okay, pick one of the book here. And he picked the Weather Almanac. I don't know if you know that story or not.
Yeah, you mentioned it, but you can say it again.
So he says, you have read this? He said, yes. He said, okay, now try to squeeze it. See if any water came out. Because predicting rain and all that. So he said, just having a knowledge is not the issue. The issue is what devotion you are learning it from. And that's getting to your heart. So that state, to become in that state, has to be part of your destiny. It's not going to happen just because you are... I mean, you can try, but the point
is... I know, but when you keep saying destiny, who makes the destiny anyway? We talked about it, that we make our own blueprint. So if that thought has come into you, that
no,
yes, I want to...
We make our own blueprint. The reason is there are multiple lives involved. And therefore, that blueprint is not ours. It's like saying, I do it, but I don't do it.
See, if somebody can reach that stage... वो मोक्ष की तरफ अग्रसर ऑलरेडी हो चुका है अच्छे से. इफ somebody is become with that extent onward, you know,
everybody is in a different stage.
True,
so it
true.
Doesn't matter where you are,
you, but you know, we,
the main thing is don't feel guilty about it, just do it the way you enjoy it.
You know what, we should be very thankful ki abhi humko chance mila, nahi to 10 aur life nikal sakte hain. Think about that. There are people, okay, I'm not putting anybody down or nothing, but there are people who start something and then they give up. Then they never come back to it. Even Bhagavad Gita bhi ho sakti hai. Kuch bhi ho sakta hai. Right?
I got pushed by Satyan actually, Sreya's husband. I was not going to join.
I think he's the one who told her, hey, ye log ka class chale. What time pe hum log teen jan the class mein.
Ah, right.
You know? So he, Satyan told him, hey, why don't you go?
And look at that. Satyan convinced him and he doesn't attend it.
Well, Satyan may be doing his own journey. Yeah, he knows
exactly.
That's
the point. The moment you know that you know something, you cannot learn anything.
Yeah.
And you know, like,
an important point which nobody understands.
One of them,
many people, they have gone to Vivekananda Ramakrishna school in their young age. So they figured they learned everything. So they have nothing to learn. So that's the way it works.
But in Bhagavad Gita, nothing is about only learning. It's all about doing. Because khali leke baith jao to, like,
about internalizing.
Yes.
That is the main thing.
So by maine bola na, to reading Gita again and again, it gives us some kind of heat to make us do things in our life in that mode. That's what it does. You know, yaad dilate baar baar. कि भाई करो जाके तो एक दिन करेंगे, यू नो, बेसिकली. सो खाली खाली पढ़ने से भी कुछ नहीं होने वाला, यू नो. और एक आई वाज जस्ट गोइंग टू टेल यू दैट वन लेडी टोल्ड मी, ओ यू डू गीता क्लास, आई सेड यू कैन जॉइन. अरे बाबा, मेरे को तो गीता के बारे में कुछ नहीं मालूम, आई कैन नॉट जॉइन. आई सेड दैट्स व्हाई यू नीड टू जॉइन. दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट शी टोल्ड मी. यू नो, मैंने कभी पढ़ी नहीं है तो आई कैन नॉट जॉइन. आई सेड माय गॉड. So I could not convince her, but that's okay. You know, my job is just to tell people. If they want to join, that's up to them, you know. So that's what it is. That it is. These are things.
So at Joe's point of view, like bhagya, jab hamara time aayega tabhi hum seekhenge. My point.